Welcome, welcome, welcome to WATC 57. You're on the move with yours truly, JoAnna Ward, and we appreciate your time, your attention, but we more appreciate your participation. And you know this is all about movement, so we want you to get up and to work out and warm up with us. But I have some guests I would like to introduce you guys to, because it's always better when you have regular people who do regular jobs and regular lives, and there aren't trainers participating in something that I want you to do. So I'm going to bring up Miss Yolanda Williams. Hello. You're going to take a sit. You can just stand right there. And then we're going to bring up Pastor and Coach Tina McCray. Come on, come on, come on. You're going to stand right here. And if you don't know what these are basic bands. You can find them on our website at joinawardfitness.com. And the reason that we have this is because we're going to do some resistance training in our upper body and lower body. And then we're going to do some sculpting and toning on this step as well. So that's why you see these things. But we're going to warm up first so we can just put these bands on the box, ladies.
And every week people would pass him by. But Peter rolled up on him and said, "Simmering gold have I none, but such as I have, I give unto thee."
So,
if you wanna be free, just look at me now. From nothing
to something you made me. Out of the ashes you saved me. Look where I am, and it's crazy. Look where I am. It's crazy. I ain't depressed no more. Ain't got the beg no more. Come on, y'all, we're going side to side. When the doubt comes in, you made me stay. And when the thrones, you tell me your play. Single, 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 single. I was down and down, but he came through in the nick of time. All of my plans, he blessed it. All of the shots, you missed me. I am a new, I've been renewed. I got the juice, so look at me now. I'm stronger. Look at me now. I'm wiser. Look at me now. I'm better. Look at me now. Look at me now. Never thought I'd make it out. Surrounded by the trouble, I was in, can't believe that. Good job. Side to side lunge. You could come through, yet you did it again. All right, we're gonna straighten that out for a punch. Be a lesson, was a blessing. Good job, three more. Two, one, take it up. It won't, again. Breathe in here. Pick it up, 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 up. Push it up. Take it down. Good job. You know like I know. Take it here. Other side. Other side. Other side. You blocked it. Two more. Last one. Will never go away. It won't, it won't, it won't. I made it. Did y'all make it? Yes. I made it. I made it.
You did it.
You did it.
You did it.
Who did it?
I made it.
I made it.
I made it.
I made it.
You did it.
Again, right? Over and over, right? Over and over, right?
I made it.
I made it. Look at me now. All right, all right, all right. Y'all, let's grab these bands. Let's grab these bands. Let's grab these bands and create a burn. Woo! Thank you. The band creates a burn. That's the way your muscles learn. They don't learn without a burn. Do they?
No.
What's the good in trying to challenge the muscle you don't work to a burn? So we're gonna start with this upper body. We're gonna make sure we breast the sweat. We're gonna take the arms out here. Now, if this is too hard for you, you're gonna bring your arms in here, okay? That's gonna make it a little bit easier. But if you wanna start out here, you can bring it in once it starts burning, you can bring it in. Once it starts burning, you can bring it in. Let's say it again. Once it starts burning, ah! Here we go. One, come on. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. No burn to bring it in. Okay, I'm proud of y'all. That's what's up. We're gonna take that left hand up here. Right hand is gonna be facing down, and we're gonna go like this. 4, 5, 6, bend it. 7, bend that elbow on the right hand, on the left side. Sorry. Give me 10 more. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now, all we're gonna do is switch the hands over, bend that elbow on the right, keep that hand flat on the left, and we're gonna do 20 here. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 11. Last 10. Good. Uh-huh. That's it. Uh-huh. Yeah. Good job. Well, okay, ain't no bringing it up in here, is it? So we're gonna take it up here. We're gonna put it around our ankles. Really? Really? Is that what we're gonna say? It's time. That's old school music right there. We should skate, this is skate music. Hey, y'all, check out the producers of this episode. It's their musical choice. So if you like it, let us know. We gonna come here. Count it out for 20. 20.
19,
18, good job.
17,
16, skate, 15, skate.
14,
uh-huh.
13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8.
7 to switch.
6.
Good job.
5, 4.
2 more.
2, and 1.
Switch sides.
20,
uh-huh.
19,
what?
16,
uh-huh.
18,
what?
14,
get it.
13,
uh-huh.
12,
yeah.
11,
uh-huh.
10, 9,
keep it going.
8, 7,
uh-huh.
6,
woo!
5, 4, 3, 2, and 1.
Alternate. 20.
19, 18, 17, 15, 14, 13, 12, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3.
Get ready to double it up on the right. Double right. Double left. Double. 3. Feel the burn! It's the way muscles learn! Feel that burn! It's the way muscles learn! Burn it, burn it! How you go, Shotty? Burn that fat. You better.
Burn that fat.
You better.
Burn that fat.
Ah!
Burn that fat.
That's right. Y'all.
Five.
Two more on the left. Two more on the right. Hold it. How was that? All right. So we're gonna take that left leg up. And we're gonna take it back and stand it back up. Back and up. Back and up. Back. Good job. 20. As far as you can. Breathe. 17. 16. What? 14. Burn it.
13.
That's right, that's right.
12.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
11.
Good job, good job.
10.
Way to work, way to work.
9.
Let's go, let's go.
8.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
7.
Work it.
6.
Even if you don't have a band, you can do it.
5.
What? What?
4.
Get it, get it.
3.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
2.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
1.
Switch sides, switch sides. Oh, you forgot about the left leg. Let's go. That's number 3. 4. Come on. 5. We got 15 more. 15. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. 13.
13.
Yeah.
12.
Good job.
11.
Uh-huh.
10.
You got it.
9. 8.
Burn those buns.
7.
Burn it.
6.
You almost there.
5.
Have fun with it.
4.
Faith and fitness.
3.
You got it.
2.
Uh-huh.
4.
Awesome. Now we're gonna have fun with the bands. We're gonna be like, ooh. Crazy. And we're gonna move the box. We're going from the bands to the box. So what I'm gonna get you guys to do is you're gonna have a seat here like so, if you can. And you're gonna lift up here. So you can sit on that side and she can sit on this side. Let's see what y'all got. Got it? Let me see what you got. So you can lean back on each other if you need to. You can lean all the way back if you need more space. And you're gonna lift those legs up. No, straight up, straight up. Stop cheating, Charlie. Straight them out. Now lift. Touch my hand. Oh, you do one at a time. Oh, you gonna do both of them anyway. You say you ain't mama ain't raised on punk. Invade and raised on punk. You gonna do both of them? Come on, do both of them like you were doing. There you go. Good job. Go on, do it, Tina. Show Gary now. Okay. Okay, that's Coach Tina McCray. Okay, okay, that's Coach Tina McCray. Y'all give me 8 more. 7, 6, 5, 4, good.
2,
all right, good job. Take a deep breath. So what you guys are gonna do is you're just gonna turn side to side and do those pedals. You're gonna pedal your feet like you're riding a bike and you're just gonna switch side to side. Let's go, come on. Pedal your feet. No, no, just where you are, just pedal your feet like you're riding a bike. Is that how you ride a bike? Uh-huh, uh-huh. But I really wanted y'all to move y'all hands side to side, but y'all, and pedal your feet. Come on, bend on knees like you're riding a bike. Like this, like you're riding a bike, yeah. Get it, get it, get it. That's what I'm talking about right there. Do it, do it. Ain't nothing to it. Get it, get it. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Take a breath and a breather. We're gonna kill that music for right now. Thank you guys so much for joining us. Give these ladies a hand. They did that. They did that with the box and the bands. We're gonna go clean up so we can give you guys a great second session. We don't wanna do it like this because you had enough of this. We get ready to go get on some pretty faces and pretty hair and all that stuff. Hey, go get your pen and your paper. Go to my website, joannawardfitness.com, and we'll be right back after this break from the bands and the box.
Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you guys for sticking around after that awesome workout. We have our family from Birmingham, Alabama, the Birmingham Bible Church pastor and his lovely, lovely wife, Pam Mason, here with us to share on how they shifted from being a good church to being a great church during COVID, and they have gotten even better. And I'm gonna let Pastor Mason go ahead and do an introduction to himself and who he calls the pastor of the Birmingham Bible Church. And he says he's just a member, and I think they make an amazing team. They represent and they exude faith, fitness, and family. Welcome, welcome, welcome to On the Move. I love
Hello,
the Mason
Joanna,
family.
How are you?
Hi, how are you?
Good.
Pastor. Well, Joanna, what I was telling with you was really, I could log off. I mean, you have the pastor on. I mean, Lady Pam, she really runs the church, and so I'm just happy to be one of the members. And so, I mean, what I said to you during the break was, hey, if you got Michael, you know, why do you need Jermaine? If you got Gladys, I'm just one of the pips, if you will. And so Pam is Pam and I have been married 25 years now. We are the leaders at Birmingham Bible Church here in Birmingham, Alabama. And we're just glad to be on with you today.
Well, thank you guys for joining me. Like I said, I've been impressed with you guys for a very long time since you were in Atlanta. I believe you were at Greater's Traveler's Rest. Mm-hmm. At that time, and that was probably, what, 10, 15 years ago? I'm not really sure.
A long time ago.
And at that point, you guys only had 2 children, and now you have 4. God is good, isn't he?
Oh, yeah.
And so I wanted you to come on because I wanted to share with our community who is, it's a lot of pastors and ministers and evangelists and people who are still trying to make that shift. I want you and Lady Pam to tell us about, you know, what you guys did, because you guys actually thrived during the pandemic.
Well, yeah, to God be the glory for everything, you know, that he's done. And, of course, Pam definitely will chime in. My church is 8 years old now. And, of course, to be honest with you, we've been virtual. We started the church back in 2014 in a funeral home, Dante Jelks' funeral home, and then we moved from there to C.W. Hayes School. We were there for years, and then, boom, the pandemic hit, and so... we just begin to operate, as Stephen Thurston says, in the new normal.
Okay.
And so we literally had to make a tremendous shift and really just do everything that we were doing in person online. And it has worked out really well. I think I heard you and Pam talking about our children's church is now virtual. Every Sunday morning, services are virtual. And the great thing about being virtual is that we're now literally able to reach more people. Uh-huh. God has opened up a door with Pam and I through the One Place app. And so now we're able to be heard all over the world. And so I really believe this is a move of God. I can't speak for anybody else, but I know that the Lord has blessed us to thrive, if you will, during the pandemic. You know, one of the things I heard the Lord say was just be sure you stay connected to the sheep. And so with our Sunday live services, Monday, Wednesday, and Friday prayer room, that's virtual. Lady Pam does a very powerful segment. You've been on there.
Yes.
Winning Wednesdays, every 12 at noon. We do a study in the scriptures now. That's our Bible study. And what I'm hearing from some members is that, you know, hey, Pastor, you know, what you all have done is literally just made the church available from wherever you are. I mean, anywhere in the world, you pick up a phone, an iPad, or a laptop, you know, you can log on to any one of our services. And so, of course, when the pandemic hit, you know, I don't believe the church ever closed. I've heard that before. The church is closed. No, our church never closed. We've been on live and living color every week. And so I think it's a paradigm shift. And of course, you know, we're having a live service this coming Sunday, but you know, it's drive up, it's in person, because we are here in Alabama. And of course, as you know, we are probably one of the top states that's under vaccinated, you know, if you will. And so we have to be careful. It's my job as pastor to keep the people careful. And so, yeah, the virtual church really worked out for us. Lady Pam, you want to speak on that?
Yeah, just to add a little bit to what you're saying, you know, by being a small church, you know, we didn't have a sound engineer. We didn't have all these tech people. So we had to kind of learn stuff on our own. I remember being in that funeral home. I think the first outlet we were on was Periscope. And so we literally bought these camcorder stands, put our cell phones up there, logged into our account, and was able to show the service on Periscope. Went from that to Facebook Live, and we did all that before the pandemic. And so it didn't dawn on me until one of our members said, you know what, we were ahead of the game before the pandemic. Now, true enough, we were, but then a lot of churches started using Facebook Live. So you had all of these churches trying to use the same thing. So there was a lot of, you know, technical difficulties. So YouTube became our best friend. We YouTubed everything. So we figured out, hey, let's do Zoom. And then once we figured out Zoom, we met with the teachers. It was Pastor Mason, our daughter Mariah. She's a journalism major. And so we would sit down and say, okay, how can we do children's church? Well, let me back up. any first lady knows that the pastor is the visionary, okay? But the first lady's got to give feet to it.
Yes.
So when pastor said, I want the children to have, you know, their own children's service, I was like, okay, now let me figure out how we're going to do that. So, you know, YouTube, got together with the teacher, said, hey, we figured out how we can share the screen. Our daughter will put together PowerPoints for the children's service. So the children will log in as she's teaching or as one of our other Sunday school teachers are teaching. Then they're showing the screen. She shared, she knows how to share songs. So, you know, they can dance and what they can do all of that stuff. Uh-huh. Then of course we transition past the story time with them. So between that, just learning how to really shift. Uh-huh. And what people don't understand is that, you know, people say, well, you know, I don't like change. I don't like change. Uh-huh. We all like change. We like it when we get a new job,
yeah,
when we get a new car. You know, we like change, but there are certain things that we just don't want to change in. And so I think it's really important. Since we had the pandemic, you know, we had to change, we had to shift, but now we still have to keep those people because some people, you know, may have gotten comfortable, you know, mm-hmm. hey, I could just watch it, you know, on my phone or whatever,
wow.
or maybe they have health issues and they're just not getting out. Mm-hmm. So you have to meet the needs of the people who are online mm-hmm. and you have to meet the needs of the people who are, who wants to be virtual. Mm-hmm. Now, I will say this, we also, we thought of some ideas just to try to meet everybody's need virtually. So and this is just an example. So we were like, what can we do with the kids? Because they're at home, they're not in school, they're virtual, everybody's virtual in school. So we started having virtual zoos. A member of our church has a lot of animals. So we said, you know what, hey, do you mind, you know, coming on Zoom and let's do a virtual zoo and let the kids ask questions. So we did that in a couple of weeks. We had one last year. We having a ladies' pajama party virtually.
Yeah.
So we have people coming on talking about hair care. You know, I think we had somebody talk about it was a massage therapist. She came on. I got a psychologist coming on. Uh-huh. So because everybody is cooped up. They're tired of being in the house with their, you know, with their family, and they just need some time to kind of, hey, this is for me. And so we just kind of learn, okay, whatever people are going through, let's see if we can meet that need and let's do it virtually. I think that's it. We've done some other things. We just did a college fair.
Okay.
And what other things that we've done, James? It's escaping me right now.
Well, you know, we wanted to maintain a major connection, you know, with the youth and children. So, oh my God, for a year and a half now, you know, we've been meeting with them every Wednesday at 6 p.m. And so basically, JoAnna, it's a matter of taking the church to the people, you know, because even now, let's be honest, you know, people are still really concerned about, this virus, but God has opened up a door for his name to be spread abroad. Now, you got to think there are billions of people online, you know, every day. I mean, mm-hmm. Let's be honest. I don't want to make any assumptions, but who doesn't have a cell phone?
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And so it's a matter of, and one thing we did, of course, Pam and I, you know, we do ministry well together. And you know, I'm really not joking when I say Pam is really, she really passes the church.
I love it.
I'm fine with my role of doing, you know, I do the teaching, the preaching, the expository teaching, all that kind of stuff. But it's really been Pam who has came up with just great ideas to keep people informed, keep people aware of what's going on. I mean, Lady Pam, it's, of course, God gets all the glory, but he's used Lady Pam to do a college fair, financial seminars. You've been on the women's conference. You won it last year. And so I guess what the pandemic did, it also showed us how much many people were dependent upon a building. You know, for example, you know, we have elders meeting, and I was joking with them one time, you know, I said, how would you feel if I were to ask y'all to come and let's meet together. And one of the elders was like, well, yeah, Pastor, now I would be like, well, can we just Zoom it? And so it's really, I mean, even Atlanta. I mean, think about Atlanta. I remember when I was there, Travis Rest, great Travis Rest. God bless Pastor Smith and everyone there. But I remember there, even when I moved to Atlanta, you got to think back then, I think Skype was out. And I remember calling a meeting and bringing people from, because I really didn't know Atlanta. I didn't know people drove from here and there. And I remember a lady telling, I mean, this had to be about 2004, 2005. She said, Pastor, great meeting, but, you know, next time we can just Skype it.
Wow.
And I was like, what? She said, yeah, you can go online and you can send us a link. She said, because I think that I drove from Duncanville, something like that in Atlanta. And so my mind literally went back to that. And I just, Pam and I just began to strategize that how can we do what we do now, you know, virtually from small groups. We have small groups every Saturday at 10 a.m. and just really everything. We've literally taken everything we were doing in person and we've made it virtual.
Thank you. Thank you guys so much. Our viewers are so blessed to have you guys even come through this medium to share with us. I mean, both of you guys, a tag team, showing what unity looks like, showing what a help meet really, really looks like, and showing what a church that thrives in the midst of what could be perceived as adversity looks like. So I really, really appreciate that. If, Pastor, if you would just give us a quick resource to where we can reach you and Pam, Lady Pam.
Yeah, I will, but I really want to turn it back over to Pam. I just spoke. I want to let her close out.
But we're out of time, and so we're going to put that on the screen. And thank you, guys. Birmingham Bible Church in Birmingham, Alabama. This is Lady Pam and Pastor James Mason III. This is my faith and fitness family for sure, for fact, for faith, in the name of Jesus. And they can show you how to thrive and not just survive. You've been on the move with all of us. Thank you for joining me and letting me into your living room. We will see you guys next time. Take care.